Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now, let us see about 100 concepts in organic chemistry. We are seeing it as episode. This is the episode number 18. If you didn't watch previous episodes, I encourage you to go on and see. Here, we solve 5 problems step by step. Stay tuned. Let us see the question number 1. The starting metal all are amines there. In those amines, they are asking pKa values. Lower the pKa, higher will be the acidity. They given the choices of the hydrogen there. Which hydrogen will be acidic? Which is near to carbonyl, or near to the cyanide, or near to the ring there. Which is ring hydrogen. So there are the possibility which will be the more acidic thing. The question is about acidity of hydrogen there. So from the question and the nature of nitrogen, you might realize the question is really about acidity versus inductive effect as well as the mesomeric effect of lone pair of nitrogen. The answer is A. Let us see how. First thing will be the more acidic one, so hence it will be the lower pKa value. So here we are analyzing the pKa. pKa will be inverse of Ka. Let us see why one will be more acidic. Because it is the aromatic one. It has lone pair involving in the nitrogen, and it has alkene hydrogen, and it is anion. So total 6 pi electron. The carbonyl helping it for conjugation. So its aromatic system, it readily leave the H plus there, it will be more acidic. Let us see the third one, it will be the least acidic one. If you remove the hydrogen, their hydrogen is attached with the sp2 carbon, so hydrogen will be less acidic. sp2 carbon is more electronegative, difficult to break CH bond, so it will be very hard to break it, so it will be least acidic, so it will have higher pKa. The second thing will be undoubtedly middle, because it will be only stabilized by inductive effect of cyanide and positive charge. So if you look at the acidity, it will be proportional to Ka. So one will be more acidic, then second, third will come least. pKa will be inverse of that one. So one will have lesser pKa, third will have higher pKa. Here the concepts you have to learn is aromatic stability is higher than the mesomeric stability, then the inductive stability. Then the question number 2, they given the 4 compounds. One is borane in the cyclopentane ring and the bicyclic system and the cycloheptane which is triene form. Then you have cyclopropyl with heat on there. So you have 4 alkene with different conjugation level and different ring sizes. They are asking which one is anti-aromatic, whether 1 or 2 or 3. Here you have to know Huckel rule, which Huckel rule obeys here. You have to count the pi electron and the conjugation nature. So from the structures and possible answer, you have to know the question is really about Huckel rule versus aromaticity. The answer is A. Let us see how. Here the 4 structures are given. Other than A, we look at others. First one is non-planar, hence not aromatic. It's a bridged system, it is not a planar, and conjugation is not favorable. Second thing is non-conjugated system, one carbon is free, it is non-aromatic system. The third thing, definitely it's an aromatic system because it has 4 and plus 2 pi electron, because it has 2 pi electron, so it is aromatic. So only possibility is A. Let us see how it is anti-aromatic there. It has 4 pi electron, so it's a 4 and system. But the conjugation is how? The conjugation is favored by empty p orbital of B there, which is boron. Hence, boron and empty orbital create the conjugation and become anti-aromatic there. Here, the concepts you have to learn is the empty orbital behave like cation. 4 and pi electron may aromatic. 4 and plus 2 minutes anti-aromatic. Then the question number 3. They are giving cyclohexane with alkene and you have sulfur which is attached with oxygen and phenyl. Sulfur and oxygen are kind of halide there. You are heating it up with phosphorus. You are having side product is alcohol with alkene. They ask what is really happened to the mechanism there. Definitely it's a sigmatropic rearrangement, whether 1-3 rearrangement or 3-3 rearrangement or 1-5 rearrangement or 2-3 rearrangement. From the reactant to product, you might realize the question is about rearrangement versus involving atoms. The answer is D. Let us see how. It is a 2-3 sigmatropic rearrangement because 5 atoms only involved. Let us analyze the mechanism there. Here, the sulfur has positive charge, oxygen possesses negative charge, it near to the alkene there. So it can create the 5 member ring formation, which is a transition state. So you can see 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, bond. That's why it's a 2, 3 rearrangement. So if it break it up, you will have CS bond breaking and double bond shifting its electron there. The final product will be like O attached with thiophenol. When you use phosphine, the phosphine attract the sulfur, you have alcohol formation. Here totally 5 atoms are involved, that's why it is called 2,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. It is very rare, only occur with the unusual kind of halide system. Then the question number 4. The starting model, you have different kind of hetero system with 2 nitrogen. The first system is conjugated nitrogen with 5 member ring. Second is fused one is 5 and 6 member ring with double bond, only 1 nitrogen there. And third is a similar system with 1 more nitrogen. Finally is pyridine there. They are asking which one is more basic, whether 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. So from the structures and possible choices, you might realize the question is really about amine versus ring size versus basicity. The answer is B. Let us see how. Here the question is really about Lewis acidity of nitrogen, which is tendency to dominate the lone pair. Here the interested nitrogen should have available lone pair. If you look at the fourth structure, it is always free because ring is already aromatic, it possesses the lone pair free. So fourth have highest basicity there. The second thing, you will have first one, because it doesn't involve any lone pair of electron, but it has one more nitrogen extra there, which is electronegative because it will reduce the tendency to donate. So the one will be the next one. And second and third, here the second one, the nitrogen lone pair attached with one conjugation, and third one with two nitrogen, so more conjugation. More conjugation decreases the availability of lone pair. So third will be the least basic one. So if you look at the availability of lone pair, fourth will come first, third will come least, and first and second will come on middle. So the answer is clearly B there. Here the concept you have to learn is the lone pair always should be readily available for basicity. It should not be in the conjugation or should not be involved in the delocalization for aromaticity. Then the question number 5, the starting middle, they given alpha, beta, unsaturated ester, which is the methyl ester. They are asking you to assign the chemical shift. They given the 5 chemical shift, 19, 143, 167 and 125 and 52. They are asking which carbon possesses that one. So from the question and possible NMR values, you might realize the question is really about functional group versus NMR there. The answer is D. Let us see how. Here assigning the B carbon will be very easy, which will be higher because it attached with the alternative oxygen and with the double bond. The alternativity can deseal the carbon as well as the bond is very near, so desealing will be more. So 167 will be for carbon, which is in carbonyl. Second thing, you can assign the D because there will be a temporary positive charge on the carbon there. That positive charge temporarily create the desealing and it will be 143. The remaining will be A and E. A will be on desealing because it attached with the alternative oxygen, and E will be simple methyl group, which is 19 ppm, and the remaining will be C. You can safely assign it for 125. It will be little bit desealed because it attached with CO as well as sp2 alternative carbon. So the assignment you have to learn here is electronegativity as well as the mesomeric effect. So the concept you have to learn here is how the mesomeric effect, how the inductive effect dominate the desealing and decide its chemical shift. That's all from this episode. I hope it was easy. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below. Stay tuned for next episode.